No booing, no cursing. Respect the candidates. You are allowed to clap. Make it quick, though. And today, we will have these six candidates debating about various topics in regards to student government, the students, and university as a whole. There will be 15 minutes at the end of the questions for audience. Only two to three questions will be accepted, but you guys will all have time at the end in the meet and greet to ask questions personally, if wanted. Let's start the debate by introductions of these potential governors, and each will have 2 minutes to give a name, major, organizations that you're currently involved, student government experience, or campus life experience, or the platform that you're running. We're going to do it by alphabetical order, so first we're going to start by Mr. Tyler Vine. You have 2 minutes, sir. And Nick will give you the 10-second warning, right?
Wait, do you want me to speak at the podium or just right here?
From there.
Okay. So good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming. My name is Tyler Bonney, for those of you who don't know me. I'm 20 years old. I'm a healthcare administration major. I'm a junior here at FAU. I was a straight-A student last semester. I intend to do the same thing this semester. As far as experience with other organizations goes, I've held 5 executive board positions in my fraternity, which is Sigma Chi. I'm now the chapter's current chapter president. I'm a businessman. I hold myself to a higher standard than other individuals, and I intend to not only win this election, but leave a legacy that no other governor has done before at this school. Thank you.
Social science education major. I'm 21 years old. I was born in the hospital about a half a mile off campus, so you know I've traveled far in my life. I am the president and founder of my own student organization called the Performers Club. We hold events every 2 weeks. It's pretty successful, I like to say. And I am running for governor because, that's not one of the questions. I'm going to introduce myself. But I have a lot of experience dealing with parts of the university. I've held 3 jobs on campus. I was an orientation leader. I'm currently a resident student scholar, and I even work for Phonathon. So, you know, I got every single aspect of it. I interact with a lot of organizations all the time, and I see just like little ways that we can make everything just a little better. You know, like I feel like we can make this campus a lot more comfortable for students, get students a lot more involved than they already are, and that begins by hearing what they have to say. We have a very small group of people that kind of just control everything on campus. You know, like I'm involved in so many different organizations and so many different like movements, and it's just the same faces every time. So, like, 2% of the people, I think, 2% of campus population voted for the governor race last year, which is absolutely ridiculous. There's 98% of people who are just not being heard, and I want to give them a voice.
Confidence in me to do so. involved in different organizations, such as student government, my fraternity, Pi Kappa Phi, a political activist club, and an international awareness organization on campus. And I'm looking to get even more involved as well by serving as your governor, and I would also like to join Model UN. So over the past 2 years, I've been able to develop strong relations with students in and outside of the Greek life community, and also through residence halls, multiple organizations, and with administrators in university offices where I worked. I've served as a member of student government in the House of Representatives as a Ways and Means member for 2 years consecutively. And I've also served as a member of the Campus Budget Allocation Committee and as philanthropy chairman for Pi Kappa Phi. Because of these opportunities, I've been able to gain incredible leadership experience and a love for this school. After living 2 years on this campus, I can say it must feel wonderful to get sprayed in the face by the sprinklers while heading to class. So this is just an example of one thing that students would like to change, but don't know how. That's why I am here as your candidate. As campus governor, I want to ensure that concerns like this are addressed. I will focus on enhancing the student experience and raising overall student activity and OWL spirit. My goals encompass a wide range of student needs, and with my detailed, multi-pronged approach, I look forward to delivering results. Thank you.
Governor, the FAU campus governor, because simply, as I said, I've held 5 executive positions in my fraternity. I've done a lot for my organization. I have a lot of love for this school, and I don't see the same amount of school spirit that I have in other students, and I really want to emphasize on the importance of that. With my leadership roles, I've done a lot for my organization, and I've just recently seen the potential I have to give back that leadership experience to the student body as a whole, and I think I'd be the perfect guy for the job as far as being a campus governor.
Mr. Fitzgerald, why do you want to be governor?
Well, I absolutely love FAU. I love everything about it. I have lived on campus for the past 3 years, and not like IVA, UVA. I live in like HPT, GPT, IIT, so just in the center of campus life, and I see so many programs and so many resources that just are so well-meaning, but they can just be changed for like a little efficiency. For instance, COSO, it takes 3 days for them to print something. Don't understand that. If you walk into COSO at any moment, there is 3 or 4 people that are just sitting there on their computers. Little things like that, they add up, and it discourages people to get involved on campus. Like when I worked for when I founded my student organization, I came into a lot of difficulties where if someone not as persistent would just quit. And we need to make it as easy for people on campus to get involved, because the more easy it is, the more people that are going to get involved. And also, it's kind of become a problem where people that are in high leadership positions are always affiliated with Greek life. That most, like I think it's 90% of the population is not Greek life, and every single one of my other candidates is affiliated with some type of Greek life organization, which really needs to change, because you find that a lot of candidates start pandering to the Greek life and will never vote against anything that will limit the frats or the sororities in any capacity. And also, I really have the kind of can-do attitude where I don't take no for an answer. I can fight for that. A lot of times what school does is try to soften things and push things down, and they try to make them not issues. And so they give you these kind of like half, you know, compromises which really don't favor students. And I, as governor, will be able to be like, no, you know, it's not going to be good enough, and students really need to have their voice heard.
Representative Paul, why do you want to be governor?
My slogan for this campaign is elevating student voices to new heights, and that's just the reason why I want to become campus governor. I was not, as a first-generation college student, I wasn't aware of the different opportunities college had to offer besides just going to class. It wasn't until I joined freshman class council and I was aware of how important it is to be involved and that my opinions mean something. Someone once told me that us in student government, we don't know what the students want, we know what we think the students want. And that's a statement I cannot disagree with. I believe that if I become elected, the students' voices should matter. should mean something. And I plan to hear your voices and implement your voices into my decision by having advisory boards under my captains. I want to have different suggestion boxes in like the library, student unit, where students could input their opinions, give us ideas, let us know how you feel about the campus. And that way students will be more involved and your voices will be elevated to New Heights. Thank you.
Representative Peter, why do you want to be governor?
Hello. Well, I believe that there is a severe misrepresentation in the student government. I've just recently been involved in it, and I've realized that there are so many different aspects of the student body that are underrepresented or not represented at all. My goal is to ensure that all of these people in all these different places, like organizations like Progressive Black Men or NAACP or smaller organizations like the Vegan Club and the LGBTQ community all have representation in this in decision making. And currently, we don't have that. And I want to make sure that like we can involve ourselves with these organizations who add to our philanthropy dollars and add to our service learning dollars. I'm from Baltimore, Maryland. And I came here and it became my second home. And I want people who come here from out of state or outside this general area to see FAU as their home as well. And the first start is to get them involved in understanding the changes that we make in student government. So one of my major pushes through government will be transparency so that people understand what they're voting on and what they're, well, us being the representation of the student body are doing in order to benefit them. Thank you.
Why you want to be governor?
I want to create real positive changes for the student body. As someone who's immersed with the students and cares for all the people that I encounter, I want to serve as an inclusive voice to all. If allowed the humble opportunity to be governor, I will be the connecting piece between students and the administration. I've witnessed a need for change, and because of it, I want to implement these initiatives. Such initiatives include expanding the library hours and services to 24/7, which means the library will be open for 24 hours during the entire week. This will be able to allow students an easier, safer, and more efficient access to resources. This is an issue that students have been dealing with for quite some time and have voiced their reasons for change. As campus governor, I will have the ability and jurisdiction to help make these changes possible for students. I truly care about our campus. Conversing with students over classes and different observations about how we can make the campus better and how to make it with smaller, important steps to improve our campus experience has truly inspired me to run for governor. Besides expanding on the cafeteria hours, the library, and fixing the sprinkler situation, I want to also implement Chick-fil-A breakfast on campus. Given the knowledge from previous governor, Christopher Ferreira, I know what to do, and we will work with Chartwells in getting this achieved.
Thank you. All right, we're going to the next question, and we're going to start actually with Representative Turner, and we're going to go. All right. Second question will be, what is the major issue you see on campus, and if elected, how would you handle that?
A major issue that has driven my urge to be governor is the lack of spirit that correlates with events that encompasses the entirety of the student body. My time here on campus, I have seen a lack of attendance for multicultural events, football games, and other activities. Working with my cabinet, I will handle this issue. Working with program board, we will provide more opportunities that would offer complimentary school merchandise as a way to encourage student participation. For example, last semester outside the library, there was a group of cheerleaders and volunteers from the Miami Heat passing out tickets to a sponsored basketball game that took place at FAU, as well as handing out jerseys and socks. Everything was gone within 30 minutes because of students taking part in this. We need more of that. And how cool would it be to provide more FAU merchandise to be able to go out to football games in the fall and have all that gear for you? So, in addition, another issue that is important to solve would be increasing the diversity within student government. I plan on creating a committee within my cabinet that will act as an representing multiple organizations and providing collaborative efforts in promoting diversity, whether it's through planning events or creating programs that will be fun for all.
Things that they don't speak from the heart, and I come here in order to combat that transparency, so that we can start to be able to see everything that happens within the student government. There are so many different bills and legislations that pass that no one understands or no one cares about, and I believe that we need to mend that disconnect we have between the student body and government. Also, there's a huge division between Greeks on campus and the regular student body, to where we seem as though us as Greeks are elitist. And I want to combat that change, and I want us to come together as one student body. My motto is moving forward as one, and I intend to do that, to move our campus forward as one government and one school. And in order to do that, we need to mend those divisions, and for the underrepresented organizations that try to increase their membership and increase who they are and, you know, how people see them. That's what we need to focus on first, because it's the smaller organizations that's going to bring out those people that we want to be involved in government. In order to do this, in order to push this initiative, I want to create dialogue with those smaller organizations as well as the bigger ones and bring them all together under one roof, so we understand everybody's concerns and they can voice them. So. In order to end this, that's the major issue that I want to combat. It's that lack of transparency here that we have here.
Representative Paul, what major issue do you see on campus? If elected, how would you handle it?
Thank you. A major issue I see on campus is parking. While we have a lot of parking lots on this campus, they're not all convenient. We have two parking spots that are always empty because they're so far away from campus. Even myself, coming in the morning, it takes me 10 to 15 minutes to find parking. I believe that's unacceptable. We pay tuition, we pay fees, and we should find parking as students. The way I plan to fix this problem is by implementing night hours to become day hours. I will implement that new program by looking to see there's a heat sheet that you can look at and see when our students are mostly on campus, when is the high population of students on campus. We'll have carts that will take you from your parking garage or parking lots and take you to your academic building. I've spoken with Parking and Transportation, and this is in the process. She believes that it's not a dream, she believes that it could be accomplished. So if elected, since my hours will be under my cabinet, I can either look at their hours to see when will be most better to have this program functioning, but I believe that will fix our parking problem on campus. Another situation that I see that's a problem on campus is the dining hall closing at 7:30 on Fridays and not opening until 11 a.m. on Saturdays. Most of the students who have meal plans are freshmen and students who live in the quad. Many of those students don't have transportation to go out and buy something to eat. I've been working with the Resident Student Association and also Chartwells to implement having food trucks once a month on Fridays on campus, so that during that time frame when the dining hall is closed, the students have something to eat on campus. Thank you.
Mr. Fitzgerald, what is the major issue you see on campus, and if elected, how would you handle it?
Well, the main issue is that students feel a little disconnected from the university. They don't know where to go for problems. Like Luke said, the sprinkler system here is awful. It needs to be changed. That's part of my platform. And I don't know where to go for that. Like, if I'm now, trusted to know that their concerns being dealt with. Because a lot of the time students don't have the time to just go and figure out what to do about this. And I feel like, oh, the problem is just a little thing. But we can deal with those little things. We can make it a little more comfortable here. And also a big problem on campus is that a lot of the events that we do, especially the ones that we put a lot of money in it, aren't really attracting as many people as we could. Like, for instance, the big concert this year, T-Pain and 303, like, they're fine, but can anyone name a song by them in the past 5 years? No. We need more relevant artists. We need people who, we need to draw the crowd, because all the people that are going to these events are going to go to the events anyway. The frats are going to go. The people involved in the students are going to go. We got to get those people that are too cool for school. You know what I mean? We got to get those people who are like, I'm not going to go to the campus event. Like, I mean, I'm not saying we should get him, but Lil Pump, you know what I mean? He's in Broward right now. What? Like, we can get him instead of other people, and that'll thank you. And that'll draw, like, a big crowd of people that aren't going to go to 303 and to these little events. And then also, that also starts with marketing. The current governor right now, I've heard that she's done some great things, but I don't know any of them. And as someone who is as involved in student government, and like not student government, but in student life as I am, who doesn't know that, how do you expect incoming freshmen to? We really need to get, we really need to expand our outreach.
Mr. Vine, what's the major issues just and collected held pending?
So there are multiple issues that need to be fixed on campus. The biggest one is marketing, in my opinion. There's over 30,000 students on this campus. There's over 300 organizations. And the student government Instagram only has 1,600 followers. Huge problem. People don't know what their resources are. They don't know where to go on campus. They don't know how to get involved. So if I get in office, you better believe the first thing I do is email all of those organizations and tell them to simply just have their members follow Instagram so people at least know what's going on. Another huge problem on our campus is the parking. I do want to turn night owls into day owls as well. It's way too hot to be walking to class from that far away, and it's also just too far away in general to be walking to class from those parking lots that are out in the middle of nowhere. And then the last issue that I see on campus, FAU Lead and Serve. They do a phenomenal job of putting on so many community service events, and I think they can do a much better job, though, at getting the whole student body together to come together as one and do more service. The issue that they have, I believe, is that all the community service events that they put forward toward the community is at 8 o'clock in the morning on a Saturday. What college kid's going to get up at 8 a.m. on their Saturday to do community service? No one. So I want to be able to work with them and possibly find a way to have more available times for students to go out and do community service and come together and make that FAU community look great here in Boca. So, like I said in my introduction, I want to leave a legacy, and I'm sure a lot of you are wondering what that is. It's simply, like I said, getting everyone really together as one, getting those smaller organizations to become bigger organizations. Like right now, for example, with Alifon, FAU has done a phenomenal job raising money for Children's Miracle Network hospitals, but the only teams registered are through Greek organizations for the most part. So we need to get everybody registered on there. There's over 300 organizations, like I said, at this campus, and the only organizations people really know about are the Greeks. So that's something I want to see change. You know, that 1,600 followers on Instagram will definitely be significantly higher by the time I'm out of office if I get elected. And lastly, I want to see all the stands filled at the games, not just the beautiful football stadium we have, but the baseball games, the basketball games, the dodgeball games, everything, because you know, it's really sad when we have a football team doing as well as they are, and we have students who don't even know what conference we're in. So that's the change that we will see if I am elected as your next campus governor.
Mr. Fitzgerald, when your term as governor ends, what change do you believe you will see? You have 2 minutes, sir.
Well, the big change I want to do is a center that I talked about for student complaining. Where like the email, I feel like that's really going to get students, they're going to problems to the right programs and organizations that can handle it, we're going to get a lot done, and we're going to see a lot of participation, especially if we market it correctly, which as he said, has been a big problem. You're also going to see a lot more attendance and events. It's not going to start with merchandise. I don't know if you've ever been to an event where they give out free stuff, but people just take it and leave. That's a majority of it. I had an event for the Performers Club where we gave out free Rockstar, and five kids just kept coming in, taking Rockstar, and leaving. That's generally what happens. And then you're also going to see a lot more people that want to get involved in student government that aren't available in Greek life. There's this misconception right now that if you're not in a Greek life, you can't really have any say in student government. And it's not true, because only like 20% of the student government right now is Greek life. But that is just the misconception. And if you elect me, someone with no Greek affiliation in a very high government, in a high student government position, you're going to see people be like, oh, I'm not a Greek organization, I want to get involved. He did it, I can do it, I can even, like, so if, and it's just going to be a complete change in culture. You're going to see people that are going to get more involved, they're going to care more about the campus. There's going to be less pandering, because there's going to be more, like, more saying no. We can't, if we don't disagree with each other, nothing is going to change. If we all just sit here and make empty promises that no one's going to fulfill, like every single year, all the presidents say that they're going to get Greek life housing on campus. It's not going to happen. I'm really sorry about that. But, like, and it's just that more people in student government that actually want to make change and that actually will enact those change and not just empty promises.
And low confidence self-esteem. 7 out of 10 students will suffer from financial stress. I want to create a program that brings awareness to these different mental illnesses. With partnering with the Council of Psychological Services and Career Centers, we will equip the students to plan for the future. While it's important to learn things in college in the classroom, we're only here for about 4 years. What are you guys going to do after those 4 years? I know I plan to go to law school. What are you guys planning? I believe it's important that students are equipped to go into the real world to be successful citizens in society. Some examples of this would be, I know that a lot of you guys are in fraternities, sororities, on job campuses, different organizations, and we get so invested into our university that when we graduate, we don't know what to do. We don't know what to do next. I believe it's important that we get these tools, we plan for the future, so we can plan for a successful life.
Between the student body, like a united campus. Currently we have certain sections of people going to certain events and they don't have any idea about the other events that's going on campus. And I want to create an ideal campus where we all attend each other's events. And that's going to be through allowing, by creating a student leadership board within the student government in order to bring leaders on a bi-weekly basis together to understand and push through problems and issues that they might have. And through those meetings, we'll be able to establish personal relationships with leaders of different groups, be able to promote the different events and things that we have on campus so that everyone can attend without bias. I also want to promote law-centric programs. Right now, we have many political science majors and many criminal justice majors, and they have to go outside of the school in order to start to move towards those goals of going to law school. I want to create a program here and bring more awareness to the student government court and the Supreme Court that we have on campus, and create mock trials and career outreach programs and pre-law programs so that people who want to go and achieve law in the future will be able to do that here. Also, I want to promote and start to market the university press. They have magazines throughout campus, and they put them out on a daily basis, but a lot of people just walk past them. I want to make sure that we have good information through those outlets so that, you know, people are actually reading them and people are actually wanting to look and see what's happening. So maybe creating times on the breezeway where people just are able to talk to others about the University Press. And also, last but not least, I want to improve the Veterans Affairs. We don't have CAP card readers, which is a common access card for veterans. We don't have these in our veterans office. I'm sorry. But yeah, I want to improve our Veterans Affairs.
Representative Turner, when your term as governor ends, what change do you believe you'll see? Give us some examples, please.
All right. At the end of my term, I know I will be able to look at all the many things that I plan to accomplish. I will be able to see students enjoying their breakfast that they got from Chick-fil-A while heading over to the library on a Saturday morning, not getting sprayed by sprinklers, get a quick study session in before going to the games, and wearing merchandise that they will receive from my administration, and at the end of the night, they'll get a ride from Night Owls because they'll be open on the weekend. And just to reiterate my platform, we need to enhance student experience, improve student diversity, and revamp school spirit. And to make this happen, I will be collaborating with members of my cabinet, specifically the program board, multicultural programming, and SAVI, to be able to provide more leadership and service opportunities for students. In the past, they did an event where they went to a dog shelter and took care of puppies. I think we need to bring that back. And I'm just here because I would love to see that legacy happen and be able to see all the change that would happen towards the students.
This is something I see myself being able to do on a whole other level because of all the experience I've had. I've learned a lot since I've been here at FAU, holding the positions I've held, and I've made great relations with a lot of organizations on campus, inside and outside of Greek life, and it would be an honor to serve as your next campus governor. Go out.
I want to be governor because I see what FAU can be. I see that the structure is there. There's a lot of really, really good people here that really want to make this university great, and they have all the programs and resources to do it, but there's just little things that can be adjusted. Like, there are little things that you look over them, but little things add up. And if we make it easier, we make things more efficient, and students can get involved more, we're going to see that transpire to, like, more people going to join student government, more people throwing events, more organizations on campus. And we also have a culture here where we just kind of are passive to when like adults, not like students, tell us things. We really have to be able to stand up. Right now, I'm a resident student scholar, and there is another resident student scholar who's a trans man, and they are currently being forced to put their full name on their name tag and to have pictures of them with their name, because it's technically not legally changed, and that's absolutely ridiculous. We need someone who can stand up for that. And every time I try to talk to other people, they're like, oh, it's a state concern, we can't really do anything about that. And they just want the issue to go away, and we need to not let those issues go away. Because if people just went down, nothing would have ever happened. We gotta create conflict, we gotta stand up to these adults. You know what I mean? Like, we're adults too. We've been here for a while. I have 3 years of college education. Like, not everything I'm saying is wrong. And I have points, and a lot of other students have points. And we really need to have the student population heard a bit more. And we need to be given more responsibility. And we need to be able to stand up for things that we believe in. Thank you.
Tradition building, unity, and community development. I spoke about post-graduation preparedness, but I didn't speak on the other three. By tradition building, I mean having pep rallies before games, football games, building up school spirit so students want to go to the game. Students won't be walking around with UCF shirt or Harvard shirt. They'll be walking around with FAU gear because they have tradition. They feel connected to university. Like how we have the lane train going around when it's football season. That's a cool thing to have going around. Why is it just for football season? Why is it not basketball, golf? Why is it not hockey? I feel like building those traditions will make the students feel more connected to the university. By unity, I mean having students involved in student government. It shouldn't be just a couple of students. We should have different advisory board. We should have an open opportunity for students to hear, for us to hear student voices. To my knowledge, before I became campus action chair, there weren't town hall meetings where students could voice their opinion on different things. I believe those things should happen more often. Community development, we should be involved in, like, not to say politics, but we should know who our city councilmen is, our mayors. We should know these things because we are the next generation. If we don't care about politics and government, then who does? If we don't care about pollution, then who does? It's not just about us, but it's about our kids, their kids, and the generation to come. When a body of students come together, much can be accomplished. I believe students are the lifeline of this university. Our students' voices should be heard, their voices should hold value, and their voices should mean something. If you elect me as your next campus governor, it won't be me running this campus. It'll be us running this campus together. Thank you.
Unity, involvement, and transparency. Those are the three words that I came up with when thinking about how I want this campus to move forward. And these three words can accomplish so much. Us being together and unified as one campus is the most major thing that we can do here, because with us coming together, that's a collection of ideas and a collection of people. And then we'll move forward from this campus and be able to interact with so many different people from so many different backgrounds. We won't, like, from here, we will not just be Greek, we will not just be in certain organizations, we'll be FAU alumni. And I want us to unite so that it can actually mean something after we come from this university. By being united, we automatically become involved with one another's problems and issues, and we'll be able to develop empathy for other people who are involved on this campus that we wouldn't normally be involved with. And that's because we are unified, and we all are involved in our school and the future of our school. And together, we'll create a more transparent student government, because when all of us understand the issues that we have to go through and understand how we can solve those issues, then you can hold me as your next Boca Raton campus governor accountable for doing the things that you want to be done on this campus. And I want to be that voice for the student body. And I believe that I am that voice for the student body. And I will end with my closing statement. We will move forward as one. And I firmly believe that we can move forward as one campus. Thank you.
You have 2 minutes for your closing statement.
Okay. I just want to say my slogan is driven by purpose, inspired by change. So everything that I've been able to share with you all tonight consists with my slogan. I am driven by purpose, and I'm inspired by the change that I'll be able to create and establish for our student body. I'm thankful to be a proud first-generation student here at FAU. I'm thankful for all of the experiences that I've been able to have. I actually joined the House of Representatives in student government before I joined Greek Life. And Greek Life does not actually take over student government. There's a huge percentage of students who are outside of Greek Life involved in student government, and it's awesome that we're able to include everybody in this organization. And everything that I listed tonight, I want to make sure that all of these needs are met, and I will be able to work with my administration to make sure all of this gets accomplished. And I'm thankful for the amount of support from the student body that has come out here tonight to hear all of our candidates and all of our opinions and what we want to change. And as campus governor, I want to ensure that these concerns are addressed, and I will focus on enhancing the student experience, raising
followers on Instagram accounts and organizations within the school. I think that's the biggest thing. Everyone uses social media. It needs to be utilized more. Resources on campus need to be utilized more. And the way I'm going to change that is make sure, you know, I have on the computer and just email the presidents and organization leaders of all of these 300-plus organizations and tell them simply just, you know, have your members follow us on Instagram. Have your members stop by the student union and check us out. And, you know, if it takes hundreds of thousands of emails I have to write up, I'll do it. Because I think that the student body has so much potential to make this university the best university in the state of Florida, and we're not there yet because the students who just aren't involved and don't know what's going on.
Mr. Fitzgerald, you have 1 minute.
We'll get students involved by having events that they actually want to go to. That's like the main thing. The same group of people are going to go to every campus event, every like big concert, so we're going to get to those people. We need to start getting the people that, like I said, are too cool for school. The kids who aren't going to go to see Kesha, 303, T-Pain. We need more diverse artists. We don't just need poppy people. You know, we got to go through different genres and stuff like that. That all starts with marketing. That's going to get people involved. Do you know we have like a record label on campus? Not many people do. And that's because their marketing part, like there, is nothing. Their biggest artist right now has less of popularity than I do. I rap, by the way, you guys check out my mixtape. And like, I'm not even that good. So like, it's kind of sad. Like, why should I go to a Who Wisdom record label if I have more following? I don't even have that much of a following. So we need to grab people, but that starts with marketing and that starts with having programs.
Representative Paul, you have 1 minute.
I will get students involved by being present. Like, I don't know if you noticed, but student government is not on a breezeway. You see a student government table, I get wow, or in the beginning of the spring semester. I believe if we're present, they see who we are, if they see what we do, that's how they'll get involved. They'll reach out to us. And having different programs like FCC, how students, freshmen can come as a freshman and be involved in student government and learn how student government works. A lot of people don't know how we work. A lot of people don't know we even have House of Representatives meetings. If students are aware, that's how they get involved. So being present, having a table out, having informational sessions, they'll get involved that way. And the current governor, she has an event called At the Lots, where she caters to the community students, and she has her team set up like different parking garages that's giving information about what student government does. As next governor, I will keep implementing those programs where we will be at the laws and students will see what student government is and what we can offer.
Representative Peter, do you have 1 minute?
I believe that, as I said before, a student leadership board will connect with so many different leaders on campus. And being able to connect with those individuals will allow us to understand so many different types of people on campus who behave differently or think differently. And being able to talk to them and being able to use what they say in order to figure out what appeals to certain people that we wouldn't normally be involved in will allow us to connect with way more people than those if we will otherwise not know who they are. In addition, better promotion of the university press. We're lucky to have a good standing university press, and if people understood like the power of the press, and people got more involved with wanting to know what's going on as far as the press, then I believe that people would use that as a means to, you know, get more involved on campus if we were able to promote through that.
How do students get more involved? You know, let's say you don't want to join student government. You don't want to join Greek Life. There are plenty of other organizations on our campus. You know, there was an event that starts out at the beginning of the year. It's called Owl Involved, where it has all of these different organizations tabling. And freshmen, incoming freshmen, or people of like us, sophomores, juniors, and even seniors, if they want to get involved, they can go around to these organizations. And if we market it correctly, they're able to hear more about it through social media. They're able to actually hear about what the organization that they're willing to join, and they're able to join it. And you know, if we have that collaborative effort that I'm going to establish with my committee, having members from every different organizations being able to have the collaboration and initiative of like marketing to the students, you know, we'll be able to reach out and get them involved. There's plenty of opportunities. Lead and Serve Office, community service, leadership for all students.
stand up. Please state your name, and is it directed to all candidates?
To all candidates.
All right.
I just want to know, my name is Doug Fett, and I want to know how you guys have created a greater sense of community in FAU.
Mr. Turner, we may begin with you. You have 1 minute.
Okay, so just to go off your question, Doug, thank you for your question. The sense of community, you know, with my committee, like I said, we'll be having members from different organizations on finding ways to reach out to other students and promoting student diversity as part of my platform. And I think the great idea that I included as well, being able to raise the school morale spirit of students, is to be able to have tabling opportunities for program board as part of my cabinet. And they're going to be out there marketing towards students and being able to get more involved. Because I feel truly, if a student is involved in anything, even a club or something, they're going to do more, they're going to do well in school, and they're going to be more successful within the future. And that way, it creates a more unified campus culture.
Representative Peters, do you want the question asked again, or?
I believe community starts with leadership. And recently I was fortunate enough to go on a group leadership retreat. And I believe the same concept should be applied to other organizations on campus. I feel like we should bring the leaders on campus to a retreat where we can create an environment of team building and learning of one another, because we normally don't understand other organizations and how they operate. So by bringing all of these individuals together, we'll be able to create a personal sense of connection, like a personal connection between the organizations that would normally not be interacting with one another. So I believe allowing that to happen, as well as the student leadership bi-weekly meetings, we will be able to bring these people together, establish a personal connection, and then from there, we'll be able to branch out and be able to meet other students' needs and interests. Thank you.
Representative Paul, do you want the question asked again, or are you fine?
I'm fine. Thank you for your question, Doug. The way I plan to build a sense of community on this campus is by, again, building traditions. I believe that students should be able to express themselves. I don't know if you guys noticed, but there's a huge tree in the middle of SO and administration building. I believe that should be called the spirit tree. That tree can be used for students to express themselves. There's a certain type of paint that we can use that won't harm the tree in any way. So students be able to, artistic students or any students who would like to be able to express themselves on that tree. And by every time you pass that tree, you'll know that's a spirit tree. That's the tree we build together. That's the tree we decorate together as a university. And I believe if we had all our organizations come out together like once a month at table, that each student will be able to see which organization they can get involved in, see what each organization has to offer. And I believe that the leadership and each organization should meet together at the beginning of the semester and to plan one big grand event that everyone can be involved with and everyone can participate in.
If we get students involved. When I first started here, I was one of those kids who was like, I'm going to get my degree and go. I don't want to be involved. And then I became an orientation leader. Then I learned about the programs and resources here. Then I started a student organization. Then I started to care more about the university because I started adding to it and I started building to it. So if we get students involved, we get students making organizations, they're going to feel more home. They're going to feel like it's going to get more commuters to start living on campus. Like a lot of things I do, it's really nice that I live on campus for that. And we need better marketing. I spoke to my class today. It was about 40 people, and I said I was running for governor. I was doing that whole campaign thing. And I said, out of all these people, how many people knew there was a campus governor before I said that? 4 people raised their hand out of 40 people. That's ridiculous. And only 2% of the population last year voted in the student governor race. How are, like, these people aren't feeling involved. If we get them involved, we get them voting, if we get them to have a say, then we're going to have a sense of community, and more people are going to care about going here.
Okay. So, yes, marketing is very important, Doug. Obviously, we need to stress that a lot and market more so that people can see what their options are, but the only thing more powerful than marketing through social media and other things is through word of mouth, and that starts with leaders and organizations. And as governor, I need to lead by example with that. Managers instruct, leaders inspire, and if I can lead by example and show that all the people under my cabinet what it takes to get more people out to these events and get more people involved and show my love for the school, they're going to be motivated to want to do the same thing, and that's how we can get more students in their classrooms to just come out to more things and get more involved.
The future is uncertain, and you will not be at FAU forever. And someone will take your place in office. Someone will take your place in office. How do you plan to inspire the next generation of FAU leaders and get them motivated for the future ahead?
We're going to start with Representative Turner. You have 1 minute, sir.
Great question, Jonathan. Thank you for your question. To inspire the next generation of students, I think if we set things right with my administration, being able to have program board implementing all these different programs for the students to have the school spirit boosted, students will want to get more involved on campus, and you know, having that domino effect positively for the legacy that's going to last. With the cabinet that I'm going to establish, having different people from different organizations who are going to find the ways of enacting diversity and connecting students on campus, you know, with all of these things that I'm planning on accomplishing, it sets a legacy for the next generation of students. You know, if I'm able to get Chick-fil-A breakfast, you know, that's a thing. And we were able to do that before where milkshakes weren't there at Chick-fil-A, so we can do that too.
Representative Peters, you have 1 minute. You want the pressure of your repeat, or you're fine?
I'm fine, thank you. Thank you, Jonathan. I've always been a person who believes actions speak louder than words. And I believe that in order to inspire the next generation, it's going to take action and not just speak it. A lot of the things that were said here today are things that we actually want to do. But a lot of these things aren't things that are plausible. But like I feel like me as a student governor, I would be able to get the things that I've said that I wanted to accomplish. And that alone will inspire people who will run after me to say things that they feel like they can get accomplished and actually move towards getting that accomplished within the first couple months of their term. In theory, I believe that by doing, I am inspiring. Thank you.
Representative Paul, you have 1 minute. You want a question for your week?
Thank you, Jonathan, for your question. I believe to inspire the next generation is to lead with integrity. We could sit up here and say we want to do a lot of things for your campus, but for us to get elected and to promise you guys these things and not fulfill those promises will not be a good representation of the government. We will just be figures sitting behind a position and not doing what we said we would do. So for me personally, if someone tells me they're gonna do something, I'm gonna hold your word to it. So for us to sit here and not enact what we're saying, I wouldn't want to become the next governor. I wouldn't want to become the next president. I wouldn't want to be involved because you're just a public figure saying things and not doing things. I believe we need to instill more value into the freshman class council because those are the next student leaders. I believe that in freshman class council, we need to build more by having the current ones become mentors to the new freshmen. Because I was in freshman class council, but it wasn't as big as it was this year. So I applaud Governor Doresha Bastine for what she's done with freshman class council because she has grown from the grassroots up, upcoming leaders who will take care of student government well after I graduate, well after you graduate, and we will have nothing to worry about Florida Atlantic University on her personal campus.
Change is a domino effect. It takes one person. It takes one person standing up and saying we can do better. It's one person saying that this isn't good enough, that this isn't right. When the fans I talked about earlier about the trans male that's an RSS, when he was hit with adversity, he like no one supported him, and so he just kind of went along and was like, I guess that's okay. It wasn't until people rallied around him and was like, hey, this isn't okay. Isn't right that they start standing up, and that would create a movement. That's what needs to happen. We need to change the culture. We need to. If I become governor and I start saying no, And I started saying that these things aren't good enough, that we can do better, that these programs can be better. The next governor is going to have that same attitude. If we start the culture, if we start trying to create change and not running from conflict and embracing it, because that's what real ideals happen. And if we speak, if we continue to do that, the people are going to follow in our footsteps. If we continue to be complacent and just say yes to everything and be puppets of government, like everyone was saying, then it, we're, then the next governor is going to be a puppet of government.
So, the most important thing is to get in and execute. You know, I can sit up here and I can tell everyone here that everything that I'm going to do, what I plan to do, I can say whatever I want to say to make people happy, but until I actually get in and execute it and the community sees that there are results, it doesn't matter. And I want the next governor to be able to see that can happen and that he or she will be able to do the next thing. I know if I do get elected, whoever the next candidates will be running for governor, I'll make sure I go out of my way to meet with every single one of them, find out what their game plan is, find out how they're going to execute that game plan, so when they get into office, they already have that, you know, transition period and they're ready to go. And even though I may be graduated and I won't be at FAU's campus anymore, I'm still going to make sure that I'm a resource to them and they can contact me anytime for help, because I don't want to just be active as an undergraduate, but as an alumni of the school as well.
Very well. One of them will be the leader of campus. One of them will be elected chief of the public administration of Boca campus. Thank you. Give a round of applause to our great excitement. I want to give a special thanks to the election board. They made it possible.